how to make ice cream. Here are some types of ice cream. Custard style ice cream starts with a curd base enriched with milk, sugar, and cream. This style of ice cream has the smoothest, creamiest, richest texture and flavor. Philadelphia style ice cream contains no eggs, eliminating the need to cook a base. The texture is lighter and more delicate than custard style ice cream. It's also faster to make because there is no cooked base to cool before turning, although you do want to make sure the mixture is quite cold before it hits the ice cream machine. How to make custard style ice cream. Equipment: bowls, measuring cups and spoons, saucepan, whisk, heat-proof spatula, fine mesh sieve, ice cream maker, and a freezer container. Ingredients: 8 egg yolks, 1 cup granulated sugar, divided, 1 cup heavy ice cream, 3 cups half and half, pinch salt, 1 tablespoon vanilla extract, optional. How to make custard style ice cream. Directions: 1. In a medium bowl, whisk together the egg yolks and half of the sugar, set aside. In a medium saucepan, stir together the remaining cream, half and half, salt, and remaining sugar. Heat the mixture over medium-high heat, stirring often until it comes to a simmer, then reduce heat to a minimum. Medium. Add 1.5 cup of the cream mixture to the egg mixture while whisking constantly. This helps prevent the eggs from cooking. Repeat with another 1.5 cup of the cream mixture. How do you make custard style ice cream? Part 4. Directions. 4. Using a heat-proof spatula, stir the cream mixture in the saucepan constantly as you pour the egg mixture into the pan. 5. Cook, stirring constantly until thickened and the mixture close to the back of the spatula, 1 to 2 minutes longer, then remove from heat. 6. Strain the mixture through a fine mesh sieve into a clean bowl, then whisk in the vanilla extract. Set the bowl in an ice bath and stir the base occasionally until it's cooled to room temperature. Remove the bowl from the ice bath, cover with plastic wrap, and refrigerate at least 2 to 4 hours or overnight before turning, either in an ice cream machine or by hand. See below for tips on how to make ice cream. How to make Philadelphia style ice cream. Top rated Philadelphia style ice cream recipes to try: coconut ice cream, marshmallow ice cream, vanilla ice cream V, lazy chocolate ice cream, Rocky Road ice cream, yards of ice cream. How to churn or even install ice cream. Turning by hand or in a machine prevents large crystals from forming the ice cream and produces a smooth texture that makes ice cream feel so rich and sweet when eaten. Ice cream is churned in a machine that will generally have more air whipped into the mixture than hand churning can achieve. If you're churning using an ice cream machine, churn following the manufacturer's instructions. When the mixture is thickened inside the stir, remove from the ice cream maker and transfer it into every separate container. If you don't have an ice cream machine, pour the chilled ice cream mixture into a freezer safe container and place in the freezer. After an hour, stir vigorously with a spatula with electric crystal in order to break up any hard ice crystals. Repeat every 30 minutes or the next 2 to 3 hours until frozen. If not eaten immediately, color it until ready to serve. Ripening. Freshly churned ice cream will have the loose consistency of soft churned ice cream. To get a more scoopable texture, you'll want to ripen the ice cream before storing it in the freezer for several hours or overnight. Your patience will be rewarded. Yours. Tip: to keep your ice cream from becoming super hot as it ripens in the freezer, make sure both the ice cream maker and the mixer are kept cold as you're making the ice cream. Store: to store leftover ice cream in the freezer, place in an airtight container with a layer of plastic wrap pressed onto the surface to prevent it from absorbing colors or forming ice crystals. Add flavors to homemade ice cream. Infuse herbs and spices into the mixture as you heat the milk. Strain them out before proceeding with the recipe. If you're cooking with a custard base, let it cool slightly before adding extracts, liquors, and flavoring oils, citrus, peppermint, and cinnamon. To get the most flavor from a vanilla bean, stir it lengthwise with a sharp knife and scrape the seeds into the milk. After the bean has steeped through the pot and mixed a cup of water and a drop, using the beans so powerfully aromatic, and can be stored in a canister of thin granulated sugar to make vanilla sugar. And perfectly ripe boots to and ready to your eye from base. Sprinkle fruit, sugar, and crush it with potato masher before mixing it in. This adds much more flavor than plain chopped fruit stirred into the mix. Dried nuts, chocolate, and or compote cookies or berries. Let's now assume the consistency of soft serve, then stir in the garnishes. Pack in airtight containers and freeze them until firm. How ice cream is made in a factory. Either it's being made in a kitchen with a hand crank for a little ice and travel this time, or an ice cream maker or in a factory that prints up thousands of gallons of ice cream every day. The process of making ice cream is basically the same. The only difference is the scale of the operation. First, you need an ice cream mix. You can buy commercially made ice cream mix that is set to a certain milk plant content. Ice cream factories usually make their own mix by combining milk, cream, and sugar in a 3,000 gallon vat with a proportions of mixing controlled by computers. The mix is then pasteurized, heated to kill any harmful bacteria. And ice cream is made in a factory, part 2. The next step in production is adding flavor to the mix. There are thousands of varieties of ice cream, so just about any combination of flavors is possible, from vanilla to cinnamon to chocolate to triple chocolate fudge brownie. All is blended into the ice cream mix. In a factory, this takes place in vats that hold hundreds of gallons of ice cream, while a giant steel pan will do the mixing. In your kitchen, a large bowl and a food mixer will work, or even a wooden spoon and a muscle powder if you want to exercise. Solid chunks such as pieces of fruit, chocolate, and chunks of marshmallows and candy are added later. The next step is where an ice cream making machine comes into play. The mix must be simultaneously frozen and whipped. In a factory, this happens in a giant tube surrounded by pipes. These pipes contain chemicals such as ammonia that freeze the tube, but the ammonia never meets the ice cream. The ice cream must be plunged through the tube where it is cooled very quickly. A dasher or a blade turns inside the tube. It sweeps the mixture, introducing the air bubbles that help give the ice cream structure. The dasher also scrapes the sides of the tube, clearing off ice crystals that form there. This prevents large ice crystals from ruining the texture and texture of the ice cream. All the elements of this process are carefully monitored and controlled by computers. Most homemade ice cream shops use a batch freezer for this step, where the same process happens on a smaller scale. How ice cream is made in a factory, part 3. One of the ice creams comes out of the ice cream maker. The process isn't finished. At this point, the mixture is frozen and it's still soft. Large chunks of candy and other goodies are now added. Then the ice cream is placed into containers. The ice cream machines pour straight into cartons or buckets, or it can be extruded into shapes that have wooden sticks released into them for individual treats. Now the ice cream needs to be reduced to a very low temperature, 0 degrees Fahrenheit or below. Factories make it even colder since they need the ice cream to stay frozen while it is packaged and loaded into trucks. It needs to be very cold to freeze the ice cream very quickly and prevent the formation of large ice crystals. This process is known as hardening. Soft serve is simply the ice cream that has not gone through this process. Thank you.